Monkeys off the back.
Oh, curious.
Did he pull?
You might think you're Michael, but
yeah.
The monkey.
Yeah, because he said he brought it in about three times and he said this number doesn't exist. I sent it to him.
Beautiful touch.
I said again, I think the ladies is about to.
I'll say that now.
We are going to see about the details of our confirmation. Because some other thing, we may have some kind of experience in the case of yoga or meditation, we may have some subtle kind of experience, and we can feel something strange through our experience. But this understanding is not so. We cannot compare our understanding with any such kind of experience. So we have to confirm what is really the understanding, actually what is the meaning of enlightenment, what is the meaning of liberation, whether we have understood properly in relationship with the enlightenment liberation, that we have to verify and confirm. And most of the masters, it's related to enlightenment. Everybody has got the same enlightenment in the same way. But they mistakenly thought that the way may be different, their attainment may be different. For example, in the previous years, in the past life, in the past history, every masters having some connection with the scriptures, and they explain everything in the language of scriptures. But their attainment is original, but their expression are in the form of some scriptures. So it is just like a confirmation of the scriptures. But if they practically say something about the original state of themselves, some original picture, original statement we can have. And most of the masters in the past history, everybody is giving importance to the Atman. Everybody is giving importance to the witnessing consciousness, the absolute reality. But you may think about the life of Buddha. In the teachings of Buddha, Atman has no place, Brahman has no place. But his attainment is correct. There is no fault. Everybody is admitted, everybody is the opinion he himself is enlightened and he is liberated. There is no doubt about Buddha. He is enlightened, whether he is enlightened or not. Everybody is accepting Buddha himself is enlightened and liberated. But the terminology of Buddha is not related to the the olden terminology, just like the Atman or Brahman or God in such a way. So he used his words in a original language. There is no place for Atman, there is no place for the witnessing consciousness or anything. So in the case of, if you see the teachings of Jai Krishnamurti, he himself will not accept the concept of Atma, he will not accept the concept of Brahman. But still we all take him as enlightened and liberated. But over here, something is original. In the teachings of Jai Krishnamurti and Buddha, we can feel something original. But they don't want any reliability, they don't want to rely upon this teaching, rely upon the description of the scriptures. So without the description of the scriptures, we can describe something which is common to all of us. So the scripture is not necessary. The conventional language is not necessary. So we can say something which we actually feel in our own language. So here, so there are very, very limited persons, they are using their own language without any reliability of the olden scriptures or conventional language. So here the matter is very common, but when we go to the frame of the conventional language, we are caught up in the conventional language. But actually the matter is not so. It is open, it is clear, it is for all. And for example, when we see the enlightenment stage of each and every master, we can understand the similarity of them. That in the case of Buddha, he do not know what is enlightenment, what is liberation. But he also strived for something which is not within our reach, and we have to have a salvation for our sorrows. For the eternal sorrow, we must be free from all our sorrows. So that is the quest, that is the process of inquiry, process of approach of Buddha. And he also tried in many ways that we can get something from the sorrow of our soul, and we have to free ourselves. And for that, he also chose the path of the yoga. He also practiced many kind of meditation, and through meditation he got many experiences. As other persons, he himself also got many experiences through meditation. But at the same time, he felt the inadequacy of the meditation and yoga to solve the problem. For the time being, he may be all right when he is doing all those meditations, all those practices. But in the next moment, he will be back again in the same old thing. So, unable to proceed further, he kept himself in a desperate condition, not doing anything. He totally rejected, totally dejected. And he sat under a tree. Because he had tried every way, he tried in all meditation, all practices, and he is unable to proceed further. So without knowing how to proceed further, he simply sit without doing anything. So in that state, sitting without doing anything, he got a different kind of state or different kind of attainment. And he described the state as the state of nirvana. And he described that, I have not got the state because of my practice. No practice will bring this state of nirvana. and there is no practice, there is no necessity of practice for this, because it is our natural state. So when it is our natural state, no practice is necessary. So only thing what we have to do is to find out some state is there in the name of Nirvana. So this is the teaching of the Buddha. And but nowadays the school on the way of Buddha also they are teaching many practices, many yoga. But modern days they are going like this. But what really Buddha has found, when he give up all thing, he got some change within himself. He find out some change within himself. So the same thing happened in the case of all masters. For the case of Ramana Maharishi himself, he got the state of understanding or enlightenment at his age of 16. When he was a little boy of 16 years old, he do not know what scriptures say about enlightenment, liberation. He did not do any kind of meditation. But in spite of that, one day he got the fear of death. He did not do anything against the fear of death. That's the only thing he did. He simply accept the happening of the fear of death. So when we totally accept the happening of death, that means we totally accept the happening of our mind. When we totally accept the happening of mind, the mind flows on its own. So somewhere or other he understood. Yet he did not know what he has understood. But later when he was with some masters of some scriptures, and there are many with pandits and scholars, some Vedanti scholars, then only he put his understanding in the frame of the conventional teachings. So then only he used the word of Atman. We have to look into the Atman. So we have to inquire, who am I? So whenever as a boy, if he inquired, who am I, he will not get the answer. So he did not know what to do. Without not doing anything, he simply accepted the happening of his mind. So in this way, he got the thing. Actually, the main thing is that we have to accept the natural happening of our mind. That is the common factor. So you may look into the history of Jai Krishnamurti. So in the Krishnamurti life itself, he was expected to be the teacher of the world, and he was prepared for the post of teacher, and he was given many kind of yogic practices, and he got many state of samadhi. He had got the astral travel through his astral body, but even though he did not get the enlightenment or liberation. But at this stage, when he was living with his brother, his brother was seriously ill. And he looked after his brother when he was ill. And at that time, there was some necessity to go abroad in a ship. And Krishnamurti himself was taken. But Krishnamurti refused to go along with them, but he wanted to attend his brother. But at that time, they are belonging to the Theosophical Society. And Theosophical Society, there are some relationship with some godly powers. So they seek the help of the godly powers, whether they can take Krishnamurti to their voyage, and whether Krishnamurti brother will survive after his illness, and they ask for some prediction from their some godly powers, and the godly powers told them that nothing will happen to the brother of Krishnamurti, and you may safely take Krishnamurti along with your voyage, and nothing will happen to his brother. And believing upon the words of the godly powers, they take Krishnamurti along with their voyage. And when the ship is in the middle of the sea, some telegram came to them. His brother was very serious, And at that time they are unable to decide whether to return to the shore or proceed further. Because they are believing the words of the godly powers. So they do not know whether to believe the words of God or whether they have believed the words of the telegram. So they are so they are in a dilemma. And before taking some decision, the next telegram arrived with the news of the death of the Isvara. So Krishnamurti completely broken down. But he has the capacity, if he thinks, he can go to the samadhi state where there is no sorrow. But he is not ready to go to sorrow, to escape from the sorrow. So he totally accepts the sorrow. And he kept himself in a room, totally in the sorrow. And but whenever he come away from the room after 1 or 2 days, he was found out what he has to find out. So the same thing happened. So he simply accept his mind. He simply accept the happenings of his mind. So when, but some way or other, each and every, it is the same in each and every, it is the case of each and every master. And some person has sent some articles about Aravindra of Pondicherry. He has also described something, same thing like this. And he has also practiced many yoga and got many powers, many experiences through his yogi powers, yogi practices. But even though he got so many experiences through his meditation, he also bored with his meditations, and he is not satisfied with the experiences through the meditational practices. But one day he simply put down all his meditation practices and keep himself without doing anything. And he was not doing anything for 1 year because he simply withdrawn from all his effort. So one fine morning, he got a different kind of experience, different kind of feeling, different kind of approach. And he did not understand what has happened to him. So at that time, he had a master. And he think the master may bless him with such kind of blessings, with kind of, so with the help of the blessings of the master, I might have got this new kind of vision, new kind of experience. So he had the idea like this. And he go to that master and told what has happened to him. And the master patiently encouraged him, and afterwards he told, I myself have not attained the state as you have got. So how can I bless you with that state? So you are in a different state. You have attained what everybody has to attain. But I myself has not attained that state. His guru said like this. So Aravindar said, he himself, in that condition also, he did not, because he did not give nothing. He did not do anything for that state. But in spite of doing nothing, he got the state. But he simply say, the almighty, the Parasakti may bless with the enlightenment. So everybody in their life, they directly or indirectly, they face the situation of their powerlessness to solve their problem. So in that condition, this happening naturally. And what is the science behind that is very, very easy, because when we have to accept the functioning of our mind, it is easy for each and everybody. We need not expect, we need not be broken down by doing all the practices, all the yoga and all the experiences and broken down, and afterwards go to retreat to a dejected mood, then we need not to wait for that, wait for the broken state. So before that itself, if you are inquiry, if you are open mind, if you are free and open, And we can very freely, we can understand the functioning of our mind. For example, I have a new brand car. The car is very new, the engine is powerful, and I am driving the car 200 kilometers per hour. And one sudden emergency came, and I apply a sudden brake. The car is moving in the speed of 200 kilometer speed. And when some emergency came and I apply the sudden brake, then what will happen? The car will take a twist and it will take about 180 degrees, twist and turn. So if anybody comes, how to turn a car? If you ask a question, we may simply say, you need not turn anything. You may drive the car as fast as you can. And when you apply the sudden brake, it will automatically take a turn. So this is the case of many masters. This is the case of all enlightened persons. Because they drive rash and in their rashly, and somewhere or other they apply sudden brake and they have a twist. So that has happened in the case of many masters. But the steering is there. The steering is for your turning. You can slow down your car. You can slowly turn your vehicle. It is very easy. But if you take the car in a rash and negligent way and apply the sudden brake, either it may twist in the way or it may skid, roll and down. So everything is possible. So it is very safe, it is very easy, it is in our hand. So we can easily apply our mind. The main thing is that the open mind is enough. The open mind is enough, the honest approach is enough. And what is necessary, what is not necessary, if you are honestly and openly approach the natural happening of everything, you can easily find out. And one another example of the same master, and there are one master, he has a practice of some pranayama, some breathing exercise. And one of his master told him, if you do the pranayama for some time, you will get the enlightenment, you will be liberated. And he also sincerely doing the practice of pranayama. And but to avoid the disturbance of the other people, he dig a deep well. And he placed himself in the well. And he is living in the well for 2 years. And doing pranayama for 2 years. But when doing practice, some strenuous practice like this, in that practice also he got some experiences. But he has not satisfied with the experience, he has not got enlightenment, liberation. So after the end of 2 years, second year, he has to come away from the world. And he goes gone to Rishikesh, and where he met many masters and done many practices and everything. And he come to a conclusion, I cannot get enlightenment in this birth. So he simply decided, everybody cheated him, all teachings are cheated him, all practices have cheated him. So he was put in a desperate condition, and he decided to commit suicide. Because he is not ready to live without attaining the desired goal. So he simply decided to commit suicide. So what he was doing is that he simply lay down upon a rock, a barren rock, in the open sunlight, and he will not go away till his death. He will be simply lay down there. And when he abandoned himself in such a way, he got a transformation into himself. So here also the same things happen. So because he is totally absurd himself, he is not doing anything, he is not expecting anything, because he feels dejected, he has no work, he has no conscious work, he simply accepts what is going on within himself and out, in and out. So he simply accepts even in the case, even death itself. So in that condition he got the transformation. But later, even though he got the transformation, he thought that only because of his 2 years practice of pranayama in the well, he might have got this liberation. So, thinking like that, still now he is teaching pranayama to many students. But he has not got the liberation and enlightenment through pranayama. He might have got some practice by some experiences through pranayama, but it has no connection for liberation and enlightenment. But but every master got the same. But only because of the total negation of our mind, total acceptance of the mind, some transformation happens. So that is common to each and everybody. That happens in all cases, in each and everybody, it is the same. But here, when you look into the teachings of many masters, many persons say, for example, J. Krishnamurti or anybody else, for example, they will, in the maximum level, they will teach that you need not do anything. But somewhere or other, in certain respect, they advise some practice. Unconsciously, even J. Krishnamurti used to say, we have to choicelessly aware, we have to be attentive. So, 99% of his teachings will say, you need not do anything. But within 1% of his teachings, he will say like this, you have to be attentive all the time, you have to be choicelessly aware. So, the readers and listeners will catch hold of this 1% and reject the 99%. So, that is the failure. But here, but this is the mistake committed by J. Krishnamurti. But the 1% is the mistake. So if you did not advise like this, everybody will be clear through his teachings alone. There is no necessity for any other teachings because his teachings is complete in all respect except this only one aspect. So in the case of the many masters is like that. I have also one guru I used to say him as Theni Swami, and he also got the enlightenment taking himself to be the absolute reality, and his transformation happens. So taking himself to the absolute reality, that means for himself he has no necessity to do anything because he himself is the absolute reality. Then what else he has to know, what else he has to attain? So he simply accepts himself. So he himself accepts as the absolute reality. So that is the case with related to Nisargadatta Maharaj also. So he is also saying the same thing. But in the case of Theni Swami, if anybody goes to him, he used to say you have to dramatize or you have to be like a dead person. You have to behave like a dead person and you will got enlightenment or liberation like this. But you will have some such kind of teachings. And there are many persons who have got some clarification from me. And afterwards, as I advise to meet Theni Swami, they will be interested to meet Theni Swami. and he will say, you behave as a dead person. And the person who are meeting the Theni Swami will return to me, I do not know what to do. You need not do anything, but Theni Swami say, we have to do something, that I have to be in a deadly condition, I have to lay down as a dead person. So here, some way or other, all masters are doing some help. But afterwards, we have to free from the clutches of the masters itself. So somewhere or other they are making some confusion in their approach. Because when they are really, our approach is to the in the yogic process, we have because of the yogic process we have to necessarily get something. But in the enlightenment liberation, there is no place for getting anything. Here we have to drop everything. So the language is entirely different. But in the case of enlightenment liberation, if you expect to get something, the expectation of getting something is the problem. And many masters say, we have to get something, you have to get this one, you have to get that. So that is why we have some doubt about that. And we are confused. But actually, in the preparatory work, every masters are good, every teachings are good. But afterwards, they have to conclude. We have no necessity to attain anything. So that is the main thing we have to understand. And there are many instances for our teachings also. When many persons attending my talks, they feel some relaxation. Because they accept their mind, they accept the happenings of their mind wholeheartedly. But afterwards, they have some complaints. I have accepted myself, for the time being, I am all right. But we once again back in the struggle, the old struggle come again. They return to me with such kind of complaints. Here we have them some, our habit patterns is there. So the habit pattern has some work. So when you are convinced in the outer level, for the time being, our habit patterns may be dormant. Because in the superficial level, you are aware that you need not do anything. But at the same time, your understanding will not reach your habit. The understanding will not reach to the level of the subconscious mind. So here the problem is that it is natural. Our habit, our subconscious mind has to function. It is natural.